Good morning to one and all. My name is N. Sivacharan. I am studying in 9th class. Today my seminar topic is about plant tissues. I am studying in Lokshit tutorial tuition. Let us go to our topic. What is tissue? Tissue is nothing but a group of cells in a similar structure and to form a particular and various functions. Now let us see cells in an onion peel. Take an onion and cut the onion. Take one layer of the onion and keep it on a slide and add one drop of water and glycerin on it and cover it with a cover slip and keep it under a microscope and observe. You will be able to see cells just like this. Now let us see cells in a betel leaf. Take a betel leaf. Betel leaf is nothing but tamalapaku in Telugu. Take the betel leaf and tore it in a single stroke. Take the torn part of the leaf and keep it under a microscope and observe. You will be able to see cells just like this. Now let us see cells in a root tip. Take a transparent glass and fill it with water. Take one onion, keep the onion on the mouth of the transparent glass. After some days, the roots will be grown. Take one root tip from it and keep it on a slide. Add one drop of water and glycerin on it. Keep one cover slip on it. Keep 2 to 3 layers of filter paper on it. And take a blunt needle or brush and spread it gently. And keep it under a microscope and observe. You will be able to see cells just like this. These are the cells of root tip. Now let us discuss about different types of tissues. There are 4 types of tissues. They are meristematic tissue, dermal tissue, ground tissue and vascular tissue. Meristematic tissue is divided into 3 parts. They are apical meristematic tissue, lateral meristematic tissue and inner calorie meristematic tissue. Apical meristematic tissue is presented on the top of the stem and down of the roots, and it will increase the length of the plant and give growth to it day by day. And lateral meristematic tissue is in a lateral manner and it will increase the width like this. And apical meristematic tissue will give growth to branches, leaves, etc. Now let us see one drawing. Here the apical meristematic tissue is presented and here the another one is presented. Lateral meristematic tissue is presented here. It will increase width like this from day by day. And apical intercalary meristematic tissue is presented in branches, leaves, etc. And it will give growth for leaves, branches, etc. Now let us know about dermal tissue. Dermal tissue is divided into 3 types. They are epidermis, mesodermis and endodermis. Friends, we all have skin. Just like that, plants also have skin. They are dermal tissue. We already said there are 3 types of dermal tissue: epidermis, mesodermis and endodermis. Epidermis is the outermost layer of the plant. Mesodermis is the middlemost layer of the plant. And endodermis is the innermost layer of the plant. They'll give protection for the plant. Now let us discuss about ground tissue. Ground tissue is divided into 3 parts. They are divided into 3 parts. They are collarenchyma, parenchyma and scleronchyma. Parenchyma is useful for the plant to contain food, water, etc. And collarenchyma is useful for the plant and it is useful for the plant for serving the leaves, branches, etc. And scleronchyma is useful for the plant for giving support for the plants, etc. Now let us discuss about vascular tissue. Vascular tissue is divided into 2 types. They are xylem and phloem. Xylem is useful for the plant for storing water, salts, etc. And phloem is useful for the plant for storing food, etc. Thank you for giving this golden opportunity.